The Jackrabbit football season opens in 10 days, and our fall camp position breakdown here on GoJacks.com continues with the defensive ends. Clint Brown coaches them while also coordinating the entire defense, and he says camp has gone well, but they're ready to begin preparation for the opposition in Duquesne.
They're definitely ready to be out of fall camp. They can get to a little bit of normalcy with school, but it's been going well. I think the time has allowed us to focus on some things that, you know, maybe you lose track of because you're in a rush to get to the next thing, a fall camp. You know, I don't think anybody wanted more weeks added to fall camp. I mean, this is being honest, but I think in the end it helped us to slow down and focus on some things that we needed to focus on instead of trying to get to the next day or get to the next defense that we're going to install. So I think it's been good.
When grading the defensive ends a year ago, Brown says they performed well, but they need to get to the quarterback more often.
I thought the guys played well. Our pass rush wasn't where I wanted it to be. Those guys know that. They heard that a bunch. That's been a focus for them, and I think it's shown up during fall camp. Our pass rush has improved. I feel at times, you know, maybe we highlighted some of the inside guys that we had, and we were very talented on the inside, and we talked about that this year, that, you know, Kellen is a very good player, but we got to get home. It's our job to get home, so we can't just double-team him every snap, and he's our primary pass rush guy. And they've accepted that, so it's been good.
The Jackrabbit offense has garnered a majority of the preseason media headlines throughout the summer, but it's the defense that has been able to feed off of that hype and use the offense's greatness in practice to better themselves.
I think guys, when they're competitive, you know, we're fortunate enough to go against a great offensive group every day, and they want to be successful. And they also know that if we do our job and play great defense, we're not going to be prepared any better than by going against the offense every day. So I think it's been really easy, to be honest with you, to keep their focus on what do I need to do. We spent some time talking about, you know, you're building your house, and we need to make sure we've built a good foundation for the house now, and not hope that we can continue to build on that during the season because it's going to be too late. The foundation of what we have to do and how we're doing it has to be laid out now. They've done a good job of accepting that.
Brown will have a mix of veterans and youth to plug in this season, and the level of competition has been fun to watch.
We're a young group. Our only senior is Mason Lyseth, and he's had a great fall camp. But we're also young from the standpoint of we got a couple sophomores, we got a couple redshirt freshmen that are all pushing each other for playing time. You know, I think we have an idea of who the starters are, but we have some situational guys that I think are going to be good on first down, second down, and some guys that we got to have in there on third down. And so they've all pushed each other. And the biggest thing, I'm proud of them guys. I think they've accepted their role and who they are and what they're going to be.
The depth chart will be set tomorrow, but Brown already has a good idea who will play in the various down and distance scenarios.
Right now, if we were going to the game today, the starters would be Chase Kern and Ryan Arith. If we were playing a base down and distance team, Mason Lyseth would be the third guy in. And then kind of still figuring out who those other guys would be. And then pass rush situation, it'd be, you know, Ryan Chase and then Elijah Wilson and Austin Smenda. So we feel like we got five guys depth-wise that can give us some different things. And then you've got Daniel Callender that's pushing, and then some pass rush situations that we're looking at seriously. Are we going to redshirt him or pull his redshirt?
Brown says the strength of the defensive ends is the group's versatility, stopping the run and rushing the passer, and their ability to do both has prompted the coach to set lofty goals.
We feel like we want to average 3 sacks a game. Prefer it not to have to be blitzing to get those. And so that's been, they've heard that day one, and they've heard it again over and over and over again. And so that's been something that those guys have worked very hard on, and so I think that's one of the bigger goals. And then we always talk about all the time, you have to earn the right to rush the passer. I mean, you got to stop the run. And those guys that have played, you know, Chase and Ryan and Mason, Austin, they understand what Valley football is all about and that you have to be ready to play, and it's going to be a physical battle. And if you don't stop the run, you're not going to get those opportunities. So